Actually, I'm not going to speak on the Azerbaijan economy, but also I will try to focus mainly actually how we can achieve and what stage economic cooperation indeed in the region. Of course, it's always easy to speak about the economic cooperation because there are always winners. Even some countries are loser, but there is always winner. And from the Azerbaijan, Georgia, and Turkey economic cooperation aspect, this is win-win game. And there are only winners, there is no loser in this game. It's actually all three countries, Azerbaijan, Georgia, and Turkey, they are getting benefit from economic cooperation. Which actually starting point is that Azerbaijan is supplier country, I mean of the energy resources, and then of course if you look at the countries' economic cooperation, not only bilateral cooperation between two countries, but also like triangle cooperation between all three countries. And on the one hand, those countries have very deep bilateral economic cooperation. At the same time, Azerbaijan and Georgia are part of EU Eastern Partnership Program, which actually mainly help Georgia and Azerbaijan to convert its standards to European standards. At the same time, Turkey is a member candidate country of to EU membership. So actually within this framework, all three countries, two countries under Eastern Partnership Program, and then Turkey and the other EU programs, they are integrated within the EU umbrella, European integration umbrella. It's actually helping countries to not only to integrate European or global market, at the same time to converge their standards to European or let's say international standards. And why actually why trilateralism is important? Of course, this is crucial. On the one hand, Turkey has huge energy demand, which mainly depends on import of energy resources, mainly from Russia and Middle East. At the same time, Azerbaijan is a supplier of energy resources, and of course, Georgia is between Azerbaijan and Turkey, and Georgia is geographically helping carrying out Azerbaijan energy resources to European and also to Turkish market, and this is a triangle game. There are three parts of the game, and each country or each side are able to get benefit from this game. And in 2012 June, Turk-Azerbaijan foreign ministers of all three countries, they signed agreement, which is known Trabzon Declaration, which does not cover only political or integration or let's say transportation, integration in transportation sector, but at the same time economic integration between all three countries. And this is actually basic agreement between three countries that prove economic integration all three wings of the in the region. And of course if you look at the economic cooperation, first of all, what extent countries can invest each other, and actually what extent the part of the this is the cooperation they can actually benefit from each other's FDI. Azerbaijan invested last couple of years invested more than 10 billion USD in let's say abroad, and 5 billion USD has been invested in Turkey, and then $1 billion US dollar was invested in Georgia, and Turkey is the among top three investors in Georgia. Azerbaijan is the among top five investors in Georgia. This means actually Turk and Azerbaijan are in top five investors in Georgia. That actually has huge share in FDI, foreign direct investment in to Georgian economy. And then, of course, economic cooperation mainly is about the is about the energy cooperation between mainly between Azerbaijan and Turkey through Georgia, and of course even the energy cooperation between Azerbaijan and EU or European to European market again through via Georgia. I've said actually bypass Russia, and the all energy projects, including Bakü Tbilisi Ceyhan, they actually they are bypass Russia projects. They are going to even the TANAP and TAP, which are intending to bring out Azerbaijan natural gas resources to European market or Turkish market. This is which is a bypass Russia. And then main agreement between Azerbaijan and Turkey is the is TANAP, which is which actually signed in 2011. And the initial cost of the TANAP is the about the 12 billion USD. And the TANAP is the gas agreement between Azerbaijan and Turkey to carry Azerbaijan natural gas resources to Turkish market. And then Azerbaijan is intending to export 16 billion cubic meter natural gas per year to Turkish market. And then it's expected that actually construction of the TANAP will be start in 2014. And then TANAP consortium is planning to finish construction by 2018. That means actually starting 2018, Azerbaijan will be able to export natural gas from Shahtanis to platform to Turkish market. And of course, even the capacity of TANAP will be increased based on Azerbaijan natural gas output, and also of course, in the future, if Turkmenistan and even Iraq decide to join TANAP, and then because TANAP is not only a pipeline to carry out Azerbaijan natural gas to Turkish market. TANAP is also main part of the TAP, because Azerbaijan will transport natural gas to Turkish and European or Greece border by TANAP. And then of course, next pipeline, which is the TAP, will carry out Azerbaijan natural gas to European market. And from this perspective, Azerbaijan so the consortium is planning to extend capacity of TANAP even the 6 billion cubic meter, depends on what scenario actually will be applied, whether Turkmenistan and Iraq will join TANAP or TAP. TAP is the main Azerbaijan main natural gas pipeline or project to export Azerbaijan natural gas to European market or Italian market. And as you know, actually TAP was competed with Nabucco West, and the main difference between TAP and Nabucco West was that TAP planned to export Azerbaijan natural gas to Italian market. This is Southern Europe, but Nabucco West was the idea to export Azerbaijan natural gas to mainly Central and Eastern European market. And then capacity of TAP will be between 10 billion or 20 billion cubic meter. In the first stage, capacity of TAP will be 10 million cubic meter, and then it will be extended to 20 million billion cubic meter per year. Because the same actually, TAP is also forecasting to be implemented starting 2018, when Azerbaijan will produce natural gas from Shahtanis 2. Within the Shahtanis 2 agreement, which actually signed 17 December 2013, which is actually the project is the in terms of the budget, this is actually most expensive project in the world, which is expected to be invested more than $45 billion USD, but not only in Azerbaijan economy, but also neighbor countries like and including Georgia, Turkey, and 25 billion USD from 45 billion USD will be invested in Azerbaijan and Georgian economy. Cost of type of cost is smaller than TANAP, which is 2.5 billion USD, and also. And the same actually, TANAP will export Azerbaijan natural gas to European market, getting natural gas from TANAP in the border on between Turkey and Greece. Since I have we have limited time, I will try I'm not going to, in detail on the foreign trade relations between three countries, and even the table show that turnover of the foreign trade between Azerbaijan, Georgia, at the same time Turkey, Georgia. I mean that Azerbaijan, Turkey are increasing last decade. This time actually trade turnover between Azerbaijan and Georgia has been dramatically increased over the last decade. Then, of course, again, Azerbaijani, we have, unfortunately, I mean, my time is over, but if you look at the main economic indicators, of course, all three countries have had positive economic growth in 2013, including Georgia, Azerbaijan, and Turkey, and then we can compare, actually, how much and then, I mean, not unfortunately, no time to go to there. Then, actually, if I come up to conclusion, my conclusion is that, of course, the Trilateral is already an emerging force in the region, in South Caucasus, and then regional energy projects linked all three countries between them and also to global European market. It's not about the only economic cooperation, but also promoting peace in the region. Because our studies show that solving the conflict in the region will definitely make all Azerbaijan, Georgia, Turkey, but also all, including Armenia, all three countries better off. Because solving the conflict in the region, all three countries in Southern Caucasus will get economic benefit. There is actually a win-win game. This is not zero-sum game. There are actually only winners of the solving the problem. And of course, it's the main indicator of engaging more FTA in the region. Again, this is a fact for pushing the region for integrating to global economy. Thanks so much for your attention.